interesting conversation?
Yeah?
They hadn't thought about it from
the other side.
Being asked to do it or put themselves forward in a positive light.
Good. Okay, folks, thank you very much. Chris, will the sound just work automatically?
What, on here?
Okay, I let it go a little bit longer than I wanted to, just because the conversation that you were having was quite detailed. I think the real thing with this is we want you to empathise with the mentee, but we also would like you to start considering that walking into a situation as a mentor, whether you've got the badge on or not, whether you know the person or not, there's quite a lot going through your head at that time as well. How do you present yourself? I said to you when I started, I'm going to spend a lot of the evening with my hands in my pockets. Some people think that comes across as arrogant, overconfident, or potentially doesn't really care. I hope that it comes across that I'm comfortable and that I want you to feel comfortable. I use my hands a lot. So we're asking you to think about how do you come across in these situations and what are the people around you thinking, feeling, saying and doing? No, we don't want to get into therapy, and you're exactly right. And some people take mentoring, and we go deeper, and we get heavy. It's not about that. Just asking you to be a little bit more self-aware and really start to understand what is going through their head at that time. We're going to watch a video. We're not going to watch all of it. This is task 4 in your book. It's initial meeting. Now, depending on how you choose to work, you might want to take notes as you go through, you might not. One of the key things that people often come on this course and ask the question of is, how do I actually do mentoring? And really, as you've gone through this empathy map, you've probably started to identify that you already do it. What we're going to show you is what good looks like. And I do that in inverted commas, or the hand signals, because the first thing that you guys will probably notice is the things that you don't like about it. So try and look at the positives. Try and understand what the mentor is trying to do with their actions, their phrases, their terminology. And consider the wider things, what's going on in the background. We talk a lot about environment in coaching. What environment is the mentor setting? Not going to watch all of it, just a couple of minutes, and then we'll stop and we'll have a chat and then we'll go again. Just a volume check for me, please, Chris, if you would. And if we can blow it up. Is that okay? Yep. Okay. Just click it. Perfect. What's happening? How?
Asking about him, his experiences, trying to tell some history about him.
Okay.
Where he played, although he didn't answer that question, and then he dropped it in his leg.
Yeah.
So, trying to get, well, the person behind the coach.
Fantastic. Questions are about him as a person. That's really important. Anything else? Fantastic. And that links back to Roger's point earlier about active listening. So, context of this, Graham Carrick, Michael Carrick's brother, obviously quite an intense football career, coaches full time, now involved in mentoring, so he knows what mentoring looks like and what it feels like. Guy on the other side, he's a qualified mentor. He's a teacher in a university, a bit like Chris, but he teaches mentoring courses. Knows nothing about football. So all of his questions are coming back from what Cara is saying. He's not adding anything new or transferring any knowledge. What else is the mentor doing? Go on. anything else on body language? But he's also not square on, because that's quite intimidating. So it's sort of a half shoulder turn. You notice when he speaks, he just leans in and then rocks back, and leans in and rocks back. Something so subtle, and yet all it's saying is, I care about what you're saying, it's your chance to speak. Body language, I said about hands earlier and what I do. His probably isn't quite as invasive as mine. Quite soft and welcoming, open palms. The nod, yeah, a bit like a nodding dog, Churchill, that you used to get on your... His whole body's rocking, yeah. So potentially a little bit too much, but still reassurance and, yeah, I'm actually here. We're doing something at the minute at the FA, be here now. Not dual screening, not replying to an email, not thinking about what I'm having for dinner. I'm here in this moment with you now. Therefore, you've got my undivided attention. Everything about what he's doing with that nod and with the rock is, I'm here for you. Okay, gonna go again. Start thinking back to that empathy map. We've had a look at a lot of stuff that he's doing. What's thinking, feeling, and saying? What's going on there? Thanks, Chris. Okay, just on your tables, just 30 seconds. What have you noticed about Graham Carrick, and how he's developed throughout the last, 4.5 minutes, something like that? Have a chat on your tables. Have you?
Said he's sort of opening up more of his answers, giving more detail, yeah. He feels more confident and comfortable.
See,
and he feels the other guy's more interested.
I think some of the questions he's asked have been quite testing. You know, who's that coach that had an influence on you? Oh, God, I don't know. We just ask you guys to think about it and throw some stuff down on paper. He's sitting in a room thinking about a coaching session he's got in 20 minutes, meeting somebody for the first time. You know, quite a teasing question, trying to get something out of you.
Yeah, yeah.
What does what we know is about Kara's body language?
Not a lot of eye contact.
No.
You can bounce still quite a bit. Huh? You're sort of rattling off things, mental there, but you know he's recalling things from his past.
So it could be him recalling it. What else could it be? Why else do people avoid eye contact? Nerves? Might be a respect thing. Sometimes people avoid your eye contact for respect. Might just be way out of my comfort zone. I don't want to talk about me. Okay, I've wound the video on. I don't think we need to sit and watch the whole thing. I'm just going to show you the football bit, because I know you're coaches. So the conversation progresses, and they move away from him as a person towards him as a coach, and then what he's trying to get out of today's session, which we'll go on to show you next.